for the support of these features. And as you can see, when you attempt to create, oh sorry, it is the Visual Basic template. Any Visual Basic SharePoint developers in the room? Okay, so I haven't made such a big mistake. Okay, so as you can see here, we have different types of solutions for those different types of elements that are supported by, and just to make sure you see it, here is the visual web part, so I wasn't lying. Now, let's take a look for one of these elements, which is the business data catalog model. This is a model that you can design, obviously, from scratch using any text editor because it is plain XML, but we all know that it has been pretty rough to do it. Now, the first thing that Visual Studio will ask for us is what is the local site that we want to use for debugging. And also, it will deploy this particular SharePoint solution to the local site. So I'm just going to validate my local site, so Visual Studio checks that everything is in place for this particular site in order to be able to work with it. There's also, you might have seen it in the keynote, there's integrated support for debugging, finally. So now you won't have to attach and detach and go through different processes on your machine. You will be able to hit your breakpoints directly debugging your solutions from Visual Studio 2010. And there's also another nice thing that I would like to talk about is that SharePoint 2010 is supported on Windows 7. Right? So now you're not going to need to have a server machine, but you can have your regular developer machine running Windows 7, Visual Studio 2010, and do the debugging stuff with all your projects. So it seems that there is something wrong with my Visual Studio project, so I'm going to leave it for now. At some point it will probably become alive again, and then I will.